Think about it for a moment. From the time your alarm went off this morning to right now, as you sit in this auditorium, how many times do you think you've interacted with code? Your phone, your car, traffic lights, elevator, even this microphone I'm using right now, all these run on code. In our modern world, code is the invisible force shaping our reality. It's everywhere. It's nearly ubiquitous. Now let's shift the gear to innovation. When was the last time you had an idea? Something big or small for the better? Consider this. What is the relationship between coding and innovation? How do these two concepts intertwine and influence each other? The connection between coding and innovation drives some of the most significant changes in our society today. Coding is a way to turn your innovative ideas to reality. It's the language of innovation, the blueprint of our digital age. Coding is a powerful tool to solve real-world problems and push the boundaries of what's possible. They say you have two lives, and your second one starts when you realize you only have one. 2 years ago, I was living my first life. Directionless, stuck in my comfort zone, doubtful. Then I lost my father in a tragic accident. That ignited my second life with a burning desire to carry on his legacy. My first project was a simple one, a smart industrial cleaner. I had no prior coding experience. I didn't know what an if statement was, but this project became my introduction to coding, the first step every programmer takes. Determined to learn, I sought out a mentor. We do spend 15 to 20 minutes in front of a computer screen going over coding fundamentals. I learned many coding languages, HTML, CSS, Python, C++, and JavaScript. All coding languages have similar concepts: variables, functions, conditionals, loops. As I grasped upon these concepts, I realized coding wasn't just about telling a machine what to do. It was about problem solving, logic, and creativity. Coding became my language to turn my innovative ideas to reality. With each line of code, my confidence grew. From making LEDs blink to developing websites, from basic if statements to complex algorithms. Soon, I was designing my own circuits and coding them to life. This newfound skill led me to the world of RoboSoccer. Our first competition was a disaster. Our poorly built bots broke down, leading to disqualification. But in RoboSoccer, errors are not failures. There are debugs waiting to happen. We kept refining our code, optimizing our algorithms, and learning from our failures. Eventually, our well-coded bots led us to a 7-0 victory against college students with far superior bots than ours. RoboSoccer is a simple concept. 1 to 3 bots play on a relatively small field inspired by a football pitch. 2 are considered as strikers, while 1 serves as a goalkeeper. The goalkeeper cannot go beyond its side of the field, while the strikers are responsible for getting past the opponent's strikers and scoring the goal. You will find various types of teams in RoboSoccer, ranging from those who will go easy on you to those who will try to break your board. From those with pre-built bots and poor skills to those with advanced bots and exceptional skills. But no matter what happens on that field, it should not reflect outside the game. Never give up before you have lost, never celebrate before you have won, and never under any circumstances lose patience. RoboSoccer can be intense. Let me elaborate with an example. There were 8 seconds left on the clocks, and it was crucial for us to win that game. And we did it. With all odds against us, we did the impossible. My My coding journey accumulated in Wildcard. Wildcard is a smart school monitoring and security system designed to automate tasks such as attendance and issuing books from the library. It also incorporates RFID doors, allowing only school staff to enter, thereby enchanting school safety. At the same time, provides location tracking of the students even outside the school to ensure their safety. We accomplish this with the help of smart ID cards, LTUs or location tracking units, and wildcard stations at every school entrance. These stations are designed to allow entry to only authorized individuals and simultaneously record their attendance. While smart ID cards provide a new way to view students' information through QR codes. Wildcard's success opened doors for us. But more than the accolades, it's the coding mindset that has been my biggest gain. This mindset taught me to break down complex problems into simpler, manageable parts. Learn from your failures and keep iterating. Collaborate, because great softwares are never built alone. Stay curious, because in tech, staying still means falling behind. If I could leave you with one piece of advice, it would be this. Embrace the coding mindset. Take coding as a new language of innovation. Break down problems, iterate on solutions, and never stop learning. Remember, in coding as in life, errors are not failures. They're opportunity to debug and improve. Your second life begins when you start writing your own story. Learn from your problems, iterate on your solutions, and never stop innovating. Thank you.